It's a shame, really. You don't get power projection from taking provinces unless they go directly to you in the war. I think I'd rather the provinces went to Syria. Do I really feel that way? I mean, what is the difference between me taking Sidon and Syria taking it? It's not really comparable, the base taxes are way off. Yeah, we'll figure it out. We'll do it on the night. I'm back, Jake. How boring was the second regency after your king died at the age of 18? Oh, it was painfully boring. It was Aztec-level boring. Alright, now can we be super sneaky-like again and get our troops over to Madagascar? Jake, you get PP when your rival loses provinces in a war. We'll see about that. Like lemmings, these provinces all come tumbling down. No! Shams! You were the greatest. We are long overdue an idea. I really want to abandon exploration now, but... I'll tell you what, how is our military tradition? It's not high enough, it's not worth it. We'll just get a good old 4-4 on the case. Strange. I should have converted Madurai before coring it. That's what I normally do. Okay, let's see if we can sneak out and take back Madagascar. Risky, but when isn't it? Oh, they know my game. They definitely know my game. Well, so be it. Spain will be out of the war soon enough. Mary won the Civil War? I miss Shams. I bet Shams could have just jumped across that. But it matters not. We'll get Crimea and Tlemcen out of this war soon enough. Wasn't one of these an Iraqi corps? No. Iraqi are feeling the Coptics, though. I want maxed out relations with Iraq, because I want them integrated as well as Syria. They've more or less done their job. And they're a bit pathetic in tech. Good job on the conversions, though. Well, barring this little Coptic outbreak we have. There we go. No more colonizing. You're not allowed to. Even Yemen's getting revolutionaries when I want them. Jake, send troops to Chios. But Chios is more or less... Well, it's a strait, so I can't just jump onto it. They will probably ruin me if I try to do that. Besides, we've got plenty of war score on them. Plenty, I tell you. Alright, it's time we can get Spain out of this horrible war. Who else can we get out? Crimea and Tlemcen, I imagine. Wow, taking out Spain is going to take out so many of these guys. So we're going to say to somebody... Oman, for example. Give us your trade power. Grain, greatest trade good in the game. And now, Tlemcen. You can have Omani's trade power. Spain. You can have Omani's trade power. Everybody's getting Omani trade power. The Netherlands of India, they said. Religious revolts, we just accept demands because we don't need no tolerance. Now, Portugal, all of your friends are not very nice. They abandoned you for pretty much no money. They're probably not going to see any of that. What do you think of that? Oh man, Jake, I hadn't seen that refinement on the trick. That's incredible. What, one trade power to lots of people? I did that before. I look forward to it getting patched and having to find another way out of these horrible wars that never seem to end. So you're now transferring trade power to Spain, Crimea, and Tlemcen. So what's going on in the Gulf of Aden there? Well, I'm not seeing any Spanish power. Ach well. As the war score ticks on and the war, well, goes on, we'll be able to get all those colonies off of Portugal. Ah, call for peace, that'll be with the Ottomans. This is going to cost me fairly dearly, I imagine. But I'd rather not get that ticking war exhaustion. Yes, the war may be won, but it's not really won, is it? I don't really want that province. And I should probably take that province just to link everything up. But by the same token, I would love to make Karaman that bit stronger and reduce the Ottomans' ability to field a navy. It's all too much. I'll have to settle for that then. I suppose I don't even need Gaza. But it's cheap and it's overseas, so it'd be cheap to core. You know, if I'm going to be integrating Syria anyway, why don't I just give them these provinces? There is a little bit of good idea to that, but not much. What I'll do is Syria can have this, but I want Gaza. I couldn't core Gaza though. Ah, but I could core Jerusalem then Gaza. Jerusalem, you see, is part of Asia. Gaza is part of Africa. Demands exceed war score, they say. Well, if anybody has any better ideas, I'll go for that. Otherwise, this looks to be A-okay. Very expensive on the Diplo, though. 1, 2, 3, 4. Says it's only going to cost me 25. We all know it's going to cost quite a bit more. Jake, why you shouldn't give regions to Syria? You care about DIP more than admin. That's a good point, but it's cheaper in DIP than it is in admin. Like, half price. Granted, I do care about DIP, but it's not that admin isn't important at all. You know what, we'll go with this. I'll be getting 3, 8, 9 over extension. 9 out of 25 ain't bad. Plus, it'll give me a good bit of PP for all this. Well, maybe not good, but good enough. Oh, what? I can core Gaza? Oh, well. Maybe it's because I have that land connection. Who even knows? Syria can core up that, and I'll begin Syria's integration before too long. I want good relations with Iraq, too. Now we're looking at Syrian... Well, we'll increase autonomy if the revolt risk becomes a bit much. Otherwise, good job, folks. Get out of there. We'll figure out what to do with all of you later. Alright, we've lost our truce with you. It's high time we just finished you off. Gobble up more for Iraq, who are doing great. I'll need your capital eventually. Again, that can go to Iraq, who don't accept Armenian, but they do accept Kurdish. They won't accept Azerbaijani, I'm fairly sure of that. Yeah, the solution is more war. Yeah, we Mediterranean now. And the extra. We're going to see if we can pull off the triple missionary bug with Madurai. Right, the war train can't slow down now, though. There is still much more to be done. We'll be waiting on Portugal for a wee while, but I fear not. Occupying overseas provinces doesn't add to war exhaustion. These troops here, though, they need to get down here and deal with Adal. But we can't get to Adal unless we punch through Oman. Thankfully, the two are allied. I have no interest in Hejaz. They can simply continue to exist there. Mecca is not important to us. Unless there are events for holding Mecca as a Muslim, in which case please tell me. Also, I don't want land connection here. All I want is this one province, because it's an important center of trade, which I have a claim on. Ajuran will get involved. That's a bit pricey. But if Ajaran get involved, Mogadishu will get involved, and I can take Mogadishu center of trade as well. It'll be twice as expensive. But I mean, hey. I just want it all. May as well declare war now, whilst Ajaran want to join in. Alternatively, if I was fighting Ajaran, then Kilwa would get involved, as well as Dal. And if I made a Dal a co-belligerent, they would call in Oman. Sure, it's a lot of people to fight at once. But it's a way to get everything I want at once. Kilwa can be a co-belligerent as well. There's a triggered modifier for Mecha, and countries surrounding Mecha naturally get missions for Mecha. No Mecha events, though. Well, I don't think you get conquest of Mecha as a Muslim. Well, I can check it by looking at Ajaz. They would have it here, under their prestige. But they don't. Whereas I, for example, have the conquest of Jerusalem giving me plus one prestige. Alright, so much to be done. I'm not risking myself another regency for several years stopping me from declaring wars. Alright, you folks need to get over there. You can deal with them. The rest of you folk. There are wars to be fought. And I've covered wars, you know. What? Oh, right, that's Portugal. Jake, didn't you want to unify Islam? It's becoming less of a priority now. Given all it is one modifier, and that's it. Man, Darude Sandstorm. What a pain it would be if that revolted. But I'm sure the Portuguese troops over there would take care of it. What makes you think the East African one's going to be the long one? Is it their amazing technology? Because I don't think it is. Right, not entirely sure that you guys are going to survive this. But do it anyway. We'll need a lot more troops down here. The trouble is going to be crossing this strait. Portugal have most of my ships pegged. Maybe I should invest in heavies. Nah, our dip tech is too garbage. Also, is anyone keeping note on how much that diplo power, that peace deal, cost me? I was meaning to spend all my dip before doing it, but I completely forgot. By which I mean I'm beyond using that trick. Quality wool. Never been so happy that it's actually related to your income now. Nepal having no rebel problems, which is fantastic. Now, can our troops actually make it over? I'll be satisfied for getting them over here. Oh, no. That's a Keelwind stack. Keep them there for now. Kind of saw this coming, but we have huge military advantage over these guys. Alright, I did not see that coming. But you never do you? Alright, come on, Shams number two. Mecha I don't even want in this war, so 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Again, doing this very sloppy, but I'm just too itching for war. Yeah, just in time for another better roll for another Shams. But no, let's actually try to treasure our points for a moment. Just another waffle theme colony. Really, I'm not gonna miss these. And offensive calls out to me. We'll take it soon. Jake, why do you want all that African nations to die so badly? Well, it's simple, really. I want to get the trade power. I want 1, 2, 3, 4 provinces out of all of this. It's a little unfortunate that Malindi did not get involved, but as long as we take Kilwa, we'll be okay. And Malindi's a lovely chap. They will give us military access. Kind of glad I raised my relations across these places earlier. Ah, right, of course. Sofala, I also increased relations with you. I know I forged a claim on you earlier, but that was just in jest. We'll take Kilwa's capital, and we'll take Kilwa. Zanzibar. Now, they're blocking us off here with some light ships. Unfortunately, we don't really have any naval-minded vassals, so we are at the mercy. However, Portugal will surely want to peace out with us soon. Kind of feel bad for my vassal now. Let's save them, friend. Getting there. To be fair, there's still the whole of Germany to get, and it's still 1646, still a lot of time to be getting regencies and such. Yeah, don't remind me. Shoot. Thankfully, we didn't lose a troop. Because I don't think we did. Portugal's on to us. Forget this exploration malarkey. What we want is offensive. +1 leader shock. Let's see it, please. Oh well, it won't be a conquistador. It's more like it. Murder all of those guys and then come home in time for breakfast. Now remember, Hijaz, I don't want you in this war. I don't want your land. My vassals are doing pretty good, really. Pshaw. You call those pretenders? Alright, so who wants to know whether or not you can get triple missionaries? Hold your turn, mash left click. We got doubles straight off the bat there. But why have dubs when you can have trips? I wonder, can I scroll the screen whilst doing this? No, it doesn't take it. Well, I'll settle for doubles at the moment. I don't have all day. If somebody wants to see if you can get triples or not, be my guest. Jake, how long will you keep playing EU4 for? A couple more hours, I think. Got bags of time, you know. Yeah. You get national decline if you don't have Quest for the New World. And you're going to keep getting it. We might as well reduce military advances, because we won't be taking up in military for a while. Although that tech 20 is great for your infantry. You'll run to Sundarbans, then we'll kill you, then you, then you. And then get back in time for breakfast. Finally, dip ideas. Okay, let's see what effect this is going to take. So this would be 21 for all this land. Instead, we take flexible negotiation. And now it's only 16. Amazing. Shame we can't enforce it because we don't have the dip power. Yes! We get this event for the second time. Gain 2 mercantilism. I love it. It's meant to make you lose legitimacy, but there's a bit of a coding error. Well, hard to even call it that since it's such a minor thing. Alright, where are you going? Sundarbans. Again, get those 10 to 1s wherever possible. And just to be sure, you're not sending any more colonists, are you? Good. Alright, it's 45 for that. Well, I'll be having it all, so it makes no odds to me. It's a shame I never made Portugal a rival. And we have infantry combat ability, which is a national idea I treasure. Pop, pop, watch those rebels drop. 10% infantry combat ability. Maybe not as good as 5% discipline, but hey, I'll take it. And I'm taking your money. I want those reparations. No ifs and no buts. Well, if buts are part of the reparations, I'll take them. Man, what is with me today? Gotta drop this lewd. I blame it on the chat as usual. Triple Six Lumberjack. Jake, give me a rough overview of the game so far. We started as Naguru, we allied 3 people and took over everyone around us, made lots of vassals, integrated them, all went all the way up to Balochistan and went all the way south. Crippled Timmy, but his lands went to Afghanistan. We fought Afghanistan a lot, constantly losing because I suck at fighting in Afghanistan lands. Eventually we overcame them, we integrated most of our vassals, we united India. And now we are punching our way into Germany as best we can, but regencies are really getting in our way. We've suffered about 25 years of regency in the past 50 years. Alright, I really want to cross over, but we just can't, not while these navies block our way. We'd be able to do it fine if we brought in our own lights. Well, we might be able to do fine if we brought in our lights. Amazingly though, without their capital, they're not willing to give up. You know what, we don't even have to cross the strait, we just need to ship troops down here and walk up through Kilwa. Jake, why haven't you killed Bachmanes? Bachmanes are doing no harm to anybody there. But what they are doing is they're sending a merchant here that takes this trade power along to Ceylon and further bring it up here to Goa. They're increasing its value so much that it would actually hurt me to take their land, I think.